Tired of animating hand motions by moving each bone one by one? The future is now, old man. In this video, I'll teach you everything you need to know to speed up your hand animation process in MMD. We'll start with learning the basics, then move on to adding grip bones, creating your own hand pose morphs, and many more. First, you need to download the English PMX editor from the link provided in the video description below. Next, you need the PMX editor plugin called Grips X2. The good news is, it's already installed in the PMX editor I provided. If not, you can download the Grips X2 plugin using the link in the video description below. To install the plugin, go to your PMX editors folder, then to the plugin folder, and finally to the user folder. Create a new folder named Grips X2, then move and extract the downloaded file into this new folder. Lastly, feel free to use any model you prefer for this tutorial. Now let's get started.
Two basic hand animation.
So, to animate fingers in MMD, or any bones in general, the first step is to select a bone. You can then click and drag using the XYZ rollers to rotate it, or use the rotate button in the bone manipulation panel, and you'll see the finger move. Once you've positioned the finger, click the register button to create a keyframe. This locks the position of the bone at that frame. You'll need to repeat this process each time you want to change the hand pose. Just changing the hand pose from open to closed requires rotating all the finger bones, which can be very time consuming. The good news is, there's a plugin we can use that makes hand animations much easier.
Grips X2 plugin.
In this section, we will use a PMX plugin called Grips X2, which adds grip bones to the model. This plugin simplifies the process and saves time. It's very easy to use. First, open PMX Editor. Two windows will show up. Arrange the position of the windows so we can clearly see what we are doing. Next, let's load the model that we are going to use. Go to File, then click Open, navigate to your Models folder, and select the PMX file. To add grip bones, go to Edit, then Plugin, then User, and then select Grips X2. A new window will pop up. Increase the size of the Grips X2 window and click on the Run button. Click Yes to confirm. In the PMX view window, you'll see that there are new bones near the model's hands. These are the grip bones, which I'll show you how to use in MMD next. But first, save the changes we made by going to File, clicking Save As, naming the model, and clicking Save. Now open MMD. Load a model by going to Model Manipulation, clicking Load, navigating to your model's folder, and selecting the PMX file. Zoom in on the model's hands. You can see the grip bones we added. Each finger has its own grip bones, so we can move them individually. These two bones are used to move all the finger bones as a whole. One bone is for spreading the fingers apart or putting them together, while the other is for opening and closing the model's hands. See how easy it is to make hand poses now, unlike before? For example, if you want to make a pointing hand pose, you can do it with a few clicks. Be sure to click Register for each change to save your changes.
For saving hand pose.
Now it's easier to make hand poses using grip bones, but we can make it even easier. We don't want to recreate the same pose from scratch every time we need it in another scene or keyframe. Let's save the left hand fist pose that we made so we can use it whenever we need the same pose. First, select all the left hand finger bones and grip bones where you made some changes, then go to File and click Save Pose Data. Let's name it Point Left, and finally click Save. Now, if you want to use the pointing hand pose again, for example in frame 15, Simply go to File, then Load Pose Data, select PointLeft.vpd, and click Register. If you don't want to use grip bones or create the pose from scratch one by one, the good news is you can download free hand poses that are already available. The link is in the description below. In this section, I'll teach you how to add bone morphs so you don't have to load the preset hand poses every single time. First, open PMX Editor and arrange the position of the windows so we can clearly see what we're doing just like we did earlier. Next, let's load the model that we are going to use. In the upper right corner, click on T to open the Transform View window. Next, let's load a hand pose by going to Edit, then VPD File, click Load VPD, and select any hand pose you like. To save this pose so we can use it in MMD, go to Edit again and select Add Bone Morph. Click Yes to confirm. In the PMX Editor Morph tab, scroll to the very bottom and you'll see our newly created bone morph named New Morph 1. Click EN to put a name in English and type any name you prefer that references the hand pose. Next, let's add the new morph to the Display tab so we can see it later in MMD's Frame Manipulation panel when we register it. First, right-click the morph we created and select Copy Index. Then, go to the Display tab, select a bone group where the new morph fits best, and click Paste Index. At the bottom of the list, you will see that the new morph has been added. Save the bone morph we made by going to File, clicking Save As, naming the model, and clicking Save. Now open MMD. Load the model by going to Model Manipulation, clicking Load, navigating to your Models folder, and selecting the PMX file. Deselect the Select button in Bone Manipulation to hide the bones from the screen so we can clearly see what we're doing. In Facial Manipulation, under the Other section, select the morph that we made in PMX Editor. When you move the slider from 0 to 1, you can see the model's hand close. Adding poses like this doesn't only apply to the model's finger bones, but to any bone you want to add poses to. If you tried all of this and still find it tedious, you can try using Quick Magic, which lets you create not only full hand animations, but also full body and face animations. Just upload a video, select VMD as the format, and you're good to go. For more detailed explanation, watch my video on how to use it. The link is in the description below. That's it, and I'll see you in the next tutorial. Bye!